You know, Mark Knopfler's guitar playing is extremely melodic, and that makes him a guitarist that's worth studying. This lesson will take a closer look at his playing approach, his melodic ideas, and how he works out chord progressions. You know, his style has a lot to offer us when it comes to playing techniques and melody and harmony, so that's exactly why we're going to check out the style of Mark Knopfler on this week's Guitar Blog Insider. To achieve the Mark Knopfler sound, it's going to take some practice. You know, his technique is based around the use of his fingers. He doesn't use a pick, so most of his plucking style is, you know, kind of unique, and it's also kind of unorthodox the way he'll play things, you know. It can be developed. You have to just focus on the way that you're applying your plucking technique with the right hand thumb, index, and middle fingers. You know, some occasional use of the ring finger is going to be part of this technique, but for the most part, it's going to be the thumb, index, and middle. You know, something really unique about Mark Knopfler's playing style is his vibrato. He applies it everywhere he can. So when you're working on his style, apply that unique vibrato sound almost anywhere and everywhere, all over the place. Because, you know, in practicing playing like him, you want to work on adding that smooth vibrato onto everything. He does it on chords, he does it on single note lines, and it's a huge part of his guitar sound. Mark Knopfler's ability to create simple but strong sounding chord progressions has become a staple part of his guitar sound over the years. And when composing chord changes, he principally favors chords that operate within the diatonic key center. So that means he stays within the key that he's working in. And you know, the chords that he uses will target resolutions in very common ways, you know, either from the five chord, you know, going to the tonic chord, or the four chord. Those seem to be his most common ones. And what I've done is I've composed a set of chord changes in the key of A minor. And in the example, I'm just going to work through having a four chord resolve back to the one chord. And what I've got here is a chord progression that goes from an A minor to a G major down to an F. So that's the tonic chord, the seven chord, and the six chord. And then what we're going to do is have the four chord that's going to be a D minor, and that's going to take us back around to the top. So here's what this progression sounds like. Right, and I'm playing it with no pick. I'm just strumming it with the top of my index finger for down strums. And then when I'm coming back up, I'm just using the top of my index finger, sort of the pad, the tip of the pad for the up strums across the strings. So I'm keeping it very simple. Now, another Mark Knopfler song, you know, that has a very smooth sound to it. I actually quite like the tune. It's a sort of more of a pop jazz tune, a lot of seventh quality chords. It's called Hard Shoulder. And in this song, the feel is very laid back. It's kind of an odd out contemporary style. And we'll find him using primarily major and minor seventh chords to create a very smooth effect with the chord changes. So an example two here, I've organized a chord progression to help get you an idea of how his seventh chord approach can really affect the overall sound of the harmony. Now I have a G major progression here. It's using all seventh chords. It's going to start on the four chord of C major 7, move over across to the tonic chord of E minor 7, G major 7, and then we're going to go to E minor 7, pardon me. And then we're going to have come in our C major 7 chord, and then we're going to be returning back once again to the G major 7. So it's going to start off like this, C major 7, and then we're going to go to G major to the E minor, and then the C major is going to come back, and then we're going to settle in on the tonic chord. Couple of options you can have too on that G major 7. You could finger it where your thumb takes care of the bass note. You can get a little bit brighter sound on that G major 7 chord there. So you get the F sharp on top. It makes it quite bright, quite nice sounding. And it's also kind of a nice transition to the E minor 7, because you'll hear that F sharp moving up to the G there on top. So really look through the chords and how you're voicing them and get a determination of, you know, where you can do things with the chord changes to really enhance their sound. I'll play that again, but I'll use the thumb in the bass G major 7. And I can tell too with this, you know, idea of not using a pick and just really using your fingers to do the strumming, it allows you to dig into certain strings a little bit more. And when you want a very light dynamic attack, you can just use more of the pad of your finger on the up strum, and that's really going to give you that very light sound and the dynamics. So, you know, a lot going on here, a lot to think about, you know, in terms of the way he uses harmony, the kinds of progressions that he uses. And he'll also really stick to a lot of simple 1-4-5 ideas as well. You know, some of his stuff is very folksy sounding, and some of it has that little bit of a Nashville tinge to it. And a lot of it is just going to be standard 1-4-5 progressions in major and in minor. So sometimes he's using a capo as well. So, you know, you want to sort of think quite broad-based in terms of things, but not, you know, anything too outside and too crazy. You know, maybe once in a while he may do something like that, but most of it's quite diatonic or played within the key. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. Well, you know, Mark Knopfler's application of different melodic lines and scale runs, it's all done using very select layouts of scale patterns, and they're generally located within positions along the fingerboard. So he tends to sort of stay in an area and then, you know, make a lot of times big leaps over to other areas. It's not, you know, set in stone. I don't want to say it's always or never, but it's majority of the time it's like that. And you want to take notice of how the scales are located and how they're being applied. Now, in this example that I have for you here, example three, I've got a 12th position A minor pentatonic phrase. And I'm starting, you know, around the top of that pentatonic scale with a 15th fret second string note bend. So I'm bending that D to an E. And I'm walking down the scale, so I'm passing over a tone that's actually a scale tone there. It's not really a pentatonic note. So that's going to be the B tone at the 12th fret of the second string. And I'm coming around into a G, so I'm leading to the tone that's actually the root of the upcoming chord, because I'm still using the same progression that we had from example number one. So I'm, you know, leading into the root of the G chord, the second chord, second measure chord. And then what's going to happen next is I'm going to do one of those standard Mark Knopfler ideas where a lot of fluttery notes going on, and it's sort of a 16th note pattern that happens off of the tones of the scale. So I'm using the B and C up top to start, and then I'm going to G and A on the third string, and then I'm moving over to the D and E on the fourth string, and then I'm going to move over across from this C note at the 15th fret of the fifth string, and then walk up, going over the D and the G again, and then slide on the fourth string up into an F. That's going to be the minor third of the last chord we have in the fourth measure, the D minor. So we're kind of targeting into that F tone. Nice sound. And you'll notice he does that a lot. And sometimes, you know, when I was first learning his stuff, I thought when he was moving into those tones, it was almost like he was hitting a note that was outside of the scale, or maybe there was a chord going on that I thought, you know, that wasn't even part of the scale. But it's just that unique targeting of chord tones that he does, and he's very good at it. He has a great ear for it. So, you know, pay attention to that stuff. It's a big benefit when you're trying to learn his style. And of course, through practicing all this stuff, your style is going to get better in the process. Well, you know, in example four, I'm starting this melodic line with a classic Knopfler style pentatonic run in the fifth position on the A minor sound. And I've included this sort of staple sound of his here by outlining chords with smaller arpeggio clusters too. It's just presenting the notes taken directly from the chord voicings, and it's a cool idea that he applies quite a lot. So let's take a look, first of all, at this pentatonic run that he's using in a lot of his tunes. It's a staple lick of his. He goes in the fifth position here. He's going to start off by coming around the A there, grabbing the A into the C and back. That's between fourth and third strings. And then you're going to do this run. It's going to start with the bend on third string, seventh fret, carry over the 2/5 frets of the first and second strings there. And then we're going to have a G to an E. It's an 8th fret, 5th fret on 2nd string, pull off. And then we're going to make it around to a D tone here, coming back to the E on 2nd string, back to the D on 3rd string, pulling off to the C. Coming around to the tonic note of A again, back to the C tone on 3rd string, and then we're going to do a pull off, going from the 7th to 5th fret of 3rd string, and then 7th to 5th fret again on the 4th string. So we're kind of wrapping things up like that at the end there. I'll do it slowly for you. And we're sort of wrapping up into the next measure with the A and, you know, getting the C tone. And that's just pushing us into the chord of the moment, because that chord on the next measure is a C major chord. Then what we're going to do after that run, and if we move after we are on the C major chord, we're going to go through it with a little arpeggio trick of his. It's just outlining across those tones of the bar chord, really, you know, 5th fret G, C, and E on the 4th, 3rd, and 2nd strings. Making it up to the high G tone there on 2nd string. And then we're going to slide forward into the A. Play A again, move up to the C. So we're moving quite laterally now, getting up to a D. And then we're going to outline the chord of the moment that's going on there, which is a G major. So we're going to move across those same tones in the same way. Moving across from the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th strings, and then we're going to wrap up into the E tone on the 4th string there at 14th fret. So it's kind of an interesting run as we move up the neck. We're just playing the scale, really. There's nothing too crazy there, you know. And wrapping up into that E tone, the chord that we're ending on is the G, and there is no E in the G, and unless you treat it like a 6th, but the upcoming chord is going to be A minor, and that's kind of, you know, giving you a shot into the sound of the 5th chord tone of that A minor sound at that point. So really nice ideas going on here, and, you know, the staple Mark Knopfler lick. And then the outlines. Which is a really cool sound of his. And, you know, listening again, all the vibrato that I'm putting on, you know, putting vibrato on pretty much every note that I can. Anything that lasts for a quarter note or more, there's vibrato on it. It's just trying to make it sing like crazy, you know, just as he does. So that wraps up example number 4. But I got one more idea for you yet. And I'm telling you, this riff I'm going to show you next up here, we wouldn't be talking about Mark Knopfler if we didn't do something like this. All right, well, a Mark Knopfler lesson wouldn't be complete without mentioning his abundant application of small chord shapes. Now, his small chord performance approach makes even more of an impact due to how he applies his finger-picked technique. And, you know, you really want to, you know, sort of assimilate all of this together. And in example 5, I have a riff that's really practicing the idea. You know, it's largely based upon the sound and style of the guitar part made famous in his hit song, Money for Nothing. And, you know, the double stop chord riff here that I have, it's basically in G minor, and what's happening is I'm taking the tonic note of the scale, the G on the 4th string, 5th fret, and then I'm adding in a G power chord, come back around to the G again, and then I'm sliding down with a double stop bar chord, sort of an inversion of a 5th interval, 4th interval, got a 4th interval going on there from the open strings as well, back into this 3rd fret bar, so that's the main part of the riff there. Then I open it up, take it down to another 4th interval of the C and F tones on 5th and 4th strings, back to the open 4th and 3rd, and then I'm going to come up forwards here into the 5th fret of the 4th string, and I'm going to do another run from a barred 7th fret 4th interval, just walking down the neck, you know, grabbing at both those strings, and then I'm just going to do the wrap up there. Kind of bringing it up from that bar at 3rd fret into the bar that I'm doing at 5th fret there. Same strings. All these double stop intervals pretty much are just dealing with 4th and 3rd strings, except for that one, you know, in the second measure where I'm grabbing it into the 5th and 4th strings there. So just take it nice and slow and give you the low down on it. It goes like this. And on the Strats, you know, if you happen to be playing a Strat or a Strat-style guitar, I'm just using the humbucker right now because it's nice and quiet, you know, through the amp. But he usually likes that second position, so you get a little bit more of the snap out of the tones there. Well, you know, Mark Knopfler is all about getting each of the notes in just the right places. You know, in other words, he plays the right notes exactly the right time, and he designs and adds to the music rather than call attention to anything, you know, like his guitar hero, you know, abilities or whatever. You know, his songs like Sultans of Swing or Money for Nothing and Brothers in Arms, these are some of his most well-known pieces. And these songs, you know, they rank as favorite study pieces for many practicing guitar players, but he has a lot of other songs as well, and the more you dig into his style, the more you're going to discover just how versatile he really is. Now, in wrapping up, it's important to note that while Mark Knopfler may not rip up the neck, you know, in a shredding madness like maybe Yngwie Malmsteen or Steve Vai or, you know, Van Halen or Paul Gilbert, those kind of guys, but what he does do is he plays into the heart of his songs, and he does that extremely well. Anyway, I'd be interested in hearing your thoughts on all this in the comments section below. Thanks for your time, and we'll catch up again next week on my other channel for another episode of the Guitar Blog Insider. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.